So ayan, hello, so for today's session we will discuss about the profitability ratio. So this is the continuation of our part 3, yung activity ratio natin for last session. So profitability ratio, so pag-aralan natin. So yung mga, if we will remember the activity ratio na diniscuss natin, it is same that profitability ratio will coming or information coming from or to solve the profitability ratio will be coming from both income statement and balance sheet ratio. So profitability ratio, this indicates the efficiency of operation and firm pricing policy. So kung sa activity ratio mas pina-prioritize or binibigyan natin ng emphasis yung mga balance sheet account, pagdating sa profitability ratio, ang emphasis of analysis natin is for the income statement accounts. So just like here in our first profitability ratio, or which is the simplest, I think, is the gross profit margin. So gross profit margin, kukunin lang natin kung ilang portion ng buong sales natin is yung gross profit. So yan. So for Basket Wonders ng December 31, 2007, we have 612 na gross profit coming from our income statement account. And the net sales natin is yung 2,211. So you can see that 28% or 2.277 is allocated for gross profit. So 27% or almost 30% of the net sales is our gross profit. So dito yung mapapansin niyo since ang pinag-uusapan natin is gross profit margin, or gross profit is equals to sales minus cost of goods sold. So mapapansin niyo mababa yung portion niyang ng gross profit sa total sales. So we cannot sure for this rate kung makakover niya lahat yung expenses from operation. But for this company naman, si Basket Wonders, nakita naman natin yung income statement niya ay nakuha or na-cover niya lahat ng mga expenses. Meron pa nga siyang income. Tama. Okay. So gross profit margin, ayan, if we will compare it to industry level, guys, huwag kayong malilito dyan because it is only the assumed amount. So what we compute is the current gross profit margin of the company for 2007. So that is 27%. Compared to 31.1%, so Basket Wonder has a weak gross profit margin. So they need to implement an action plan or create other ways to generate more income from their sales. Okay, so let's move on. So ito yung trend comparison niya for compare dun sa ating industry level. So may kita nyo guys, downtrend or downside or downslope yung pagkaka-illustrate ng Basket Wonders for 2006 and 2007. Okay, so we move on to our next ratio. So it is a profitability ratio pa rin. So tandaan nyo lang guys, kapag profitability ratio, we tend to analyze all the balance sheet the income statement accounts. So katulad nito, net profit margin. So net profit is coming from the income statement account. So we will use or we will analyze the performance of the net profit based on the current year status income statement. So for Basket Wonders, December 31, 2007, we have a $91 of income or net income after tax. So it is the earnings after tax, guys, yung EAT natin sa statement. So napansin nyo, hindi kasama dun yung cash dividends. So kapag kasama yung cash dividends, hindi yun, mamamali kayo. So you need to get lang the earnings after tax. Okay? So in this ratio, the firm is taking to account all the expenses in income taxes. Compare sa ating gross profit margin, ay efficiency lang ng net sales after deducting the cost of goods sold, yung ating ina-analyze. But dito sa ating profitability ratio, the company is taking all consideration na pati yung mga ibang elements ng income statement, such as operating expense and then yung interest and taxes. So papansin nyo dito, 4% of our net sales is accounted for net profit. So almost 4% ng net sales ay ang ating net profit after tax. So ayan. So industry level, compare the company has a net profit margin. So bakit so nagtataka kayo kung bakit natin siya kino-compare sa industry rate, kasi we have, or the company has ways to measure its efficiency. So one is that we measure the efficiency internally. Ayan, yung 4.1. We use the different methods, such as yung financial analysis na ginagawa natin and computation. We do that internally because the information we gathered is from internal source or historical data ng company. But to check and to verify if the company, sasabi nyo, okay naman yung net profit margin namin, pero bakit ganun, hindi kami makasabay sa ibang company, bakit parang we are behind sa ibang company, maybe the company is not considering the industry level of net profit margin. So para maging ganito ka wealthy yung iyong business, dapat ganto din yung iyong net profit margin. So the industry level stands as standard for this ratio. So comparing sa ating Basket Wonders company, mas mababa siya ng almost half ng industry level. So that concludes na yung ating Basket Wonders company has a poor net profit margin. Okay? So yun, the company should action for any circumstances regarding this. So kailangan nilang pataasin your sales or what? Ano, magtipid, mag-cost cut, or maghanap pa ng ibang sector or variants ng kanilang sales para tumaas ang kanilang benta. So ayan yung trend analysis, makikita nyo yung red is for the industry level, and napapansin nyo na drastic talaga yung pagbaba nung net profit margin ng company, because almost half ng industry level yung behind ng ating company or yung Basket Wonders. So next, return on investment. So dito, guys, yung after we consider the two reports or the two ratio earlier, nanggaling lang sa income statement, right? But pagdating dito sa pangatlo, ayun na naman tayo, we use the income statement and balance sheet data to compute our return on investment. So return on investment indicates that the profitability on the asset of the firm. So indicates the profitability on the asset of the firm. So how much yung kinikita ng or ginigain ng asset ng company doon sa business or sa performance niya, or how much, pag inallocate natin yung net profit after tax, how much of that profit is allocated sa performance ng asset. So ito yung guys, yung net profit after tax divided by total asset. So sabi ko kanina dito, ay sabi ko last time, 'di ba, medyo unclear yung pag measure kapag total asset, because not all asset are generating income. So most of the asset natin ay nag-generate pa nga ng cost, and that contributes to our pagbaba ng ating return on investment. So usually ito yung tinitignan ng mga investor, kung gaano kalakas or gaano kabilis yung pagbawi ng kanilang investment sa, or based doon sa income na gine-generate ng company for the year. So the efficient the company is, the faster the return on investment will be. So dito, yung 91 over $2,160, that is only 4%, 0.042. So ayan lang yung kinikita. So kung compare natin siya, wala pang $1 yung kinikita ng company sa sales for this year. So yan, the Basket Wonders or the company has a poor return on investment. So for the past 3 years, 2007, 6, and 5, the company has a lower return on investment compared to industry level of return on investment. So yan, although hindi masyadong reliable kasi yun nga, because of the issue on the asset, we cannot tell about the, or we cannot see the total picture kung gaano talaga nagpe-perform yung company, because income naman tayo, 'di ba? So maybe data on balance sheet nakaka-apekto siya doon sa ating rating. So yan. Okay. So next natin is yung return on equity. So return on equity, so mapapansin nyo guys, yung lahat ng numerator natin for profitability ratio is all about, or all ay net profit after taxes. Maliban na lang syempre sa ating gross profit margin, na gross profit yung ating, syempre gross profit yung ating kinukuha. Kaya gross profit yung kanyang numerator. But to all, or moving forward, net profit margin, net profit after tax, return on investment, net profit after tax, and dito sa ating return on equity, net profit after tax. So bakit kasi mas malinis na yung net profit after tax, because we consider all the expense and taxes. So hindi natin kapag net profit before tax, hindi pa natin na-deduct yung taxes. Kapag EBIT naman, hindi pa natin na-deduct yung both interest and taxes. So net profit after tax, or yung ating earnings after tax, will be the the concrete information in measuring our return on equity. So pagdating dito guys, ayan, so shareholders equity ang ating denominator. So we measure the contribution of the company, or the performance of company, based doon sa ating investment, or yung shareholders equity, or kung magkano yung hinold natin for the company. So siguro investment wise, mas magandang tignan yung return on equity, because this shows only the amount you invested sa company. So kung magkano ininvest mo for this year, yun lang yung kung magkano lang yung ininvest mo sa company, yun lang yung i-consider natin in measuring our return on equity. Or kung sa layman, kung gaano kabilis or gaano kalaki yung balikpuhunan ng investor sa kanyang business or sa business. So in this example, we have $91 na net profit after tax, and we divide into our CARE, yung shareholders equity, common share, additional paid in capital, and retained earnings. So that is 8% of the so yung ating yung efficiency. O if ganto ka efficient yung yung ating income statement based sa at or when we compare it to or when we relate it to our shareholders equity. So tingnan natin kung ano yung ayan. So industry level, inassume na industry level is 17.9. So since the company has a lower net profit after tax, that actually is the root cause of our or poor return on equity. If we have or if the company make it more profitable for the year, maybe the return on equity will increase and will have less impact doon sa ating industry level. So yan, return on equity guys, ayan yung ang ating denominator for that is yung shareholders equity. So ayan. So we move on to our last approach for ratios. So ito yung return on investment and the DuPont approach ratio. So ito guys, actually ito ay shortcut lamang or shortcut ng ating return on investment account or shortcut ng ating return on investment na formula. So ayan. So ayan, I discuss natin muna yung components ng earning power on ROI. Diba guys, yung return on investment natin is same also with our, ayan, return on investment is computed through net profit after tax times total asset. So yun yung pinaka-root ng, or yun yung pinaka-original na formula. But return on investment and the DuPont approach, ayan, so alamin natin yung component. So, sales profitability times asset efficiency or yung asset turnover. Or yung asset turnover natin, ayan. So, yung ROI is equals to net profit margin times total asset turnover. So, paano ba nangyari yan? So, sir, di ba yung yung ROI natin is net profit after tax divided by the total asset. So paano nangyari sir yung ano sa sir paano nangyari na net profit margin times multiply lang natin sa total asset turnover is same as with the ROI or ROI formula of net profit after tax divided by total asset. So ayan. Total asset nga ba yun? Total asset. So yan kapag ayan. So tingnan niyo guys yung ating ayan yung profitability ratio based on our original formula 4.2%, and then if we use the DuPont approach, ayan 4.2% pa din. So paano nangyari yan? Paano nangyari yan? Wait lang. Yung ano. So gawin natin yung So ayan, gawin natin or i-evaluate natin yung equation. So ayan, ang sabi, ayan, ballpen. Ayan. Yung ating ROI is equals to net profit after tax over total asset. Ayan. Ay. So paano natin evaluate or sa paano naging paano natin ipo-prove na yung ROI is equals also sa ating net profit margin times asset turnover. So ano ba yung formula ng ating net profit margin? Net profit margin is net profit margin ay NPAT or net profit after tax over sales, di ba? Times sa ating asset turnover, which is sales, over total asset. So, perform the operation lang, guys. Ayan, sales, cross multiply. So, tanggalin natin yan. So, matitira ay NPAT and total asset, which is same dito sa ating original na formula. So kapag available yung ating net profit margin, multiply nyo sa total asset turnover, that will give us the same result for return on investment. Okay, let's move on sa next. Ayan, so ating return on equity, same as with DAO. So, same with net profit margin times total asset turnover. Kasi diba ang equity for finance management subject ay same as with the total asset. Okay? Net profit margin times, yung return on equity natin pala ay net profit margin times total equity turnover times equity multiplier. Ay, wait lang. Share ko yung isa. Ayan. So, ang ating return on equity and the DuPont approach. So, DuPont approach, parang shortcut lang natin siya. So, ang ating return on equity ay net profit margin times total asset times equity multiplier. Equity multiplier is equal to total asset divided by total or shareholder's equity. So, ayan. So if we if we want to prove na yung formula is correct. So, gagawin ulit natin yung ginawa natin kanina. Ayan. So, ROE is equal to net profit after tax over equity. Ayan, equity. So, ating equity. Ngayon, So yung ating ang sabi, yung ROE natin is equal to NPAT times asset turnover times equity multiplier. So ito na yung ating bagong formula. So paano natin yan i-prove? So net profit margin, ano yun? NPAT over sales times asset turnover, sales over asset times equity multiplier, asset over shareholders equity. Cancel mo to kasi sila ay cross, cross-multiply natin, then cancel mo to, then matitira is yung NPAT over SHE, which is same dun sa ating original na NPAT over equity. So, ganyan guys, kaya napatunayan din natin yan. Ayan, so much for that. Ayan, tapos na natin yan. So, we move on to our next, slide. So, ayan, summary of the profitability and trend. Ayan lang naman to. So, the profitability ratio for the company have all been falling since 2005. So, each has been below the industry average for the past 3 years. This indicates that the company's cost of goods sold and administered cost may be too high and potential problem for the company. So, di ba, napansin nyo na since yung ating numerator for all the ratio na ginamit natin is net profit after tax, medyo mababa yung kanyang net profit after tax. And that is maybe because of too high na cost of goods sold and administrative costs that affect the potential income ng company. So note this result is consistent with the low interest coverage ratio. So ano ba yung mga pwedeng naging problem ng company because they have too low or mababang income. So maybe yung inventories are too high, hindi nila masyadong mabebenta or nabenta. Maybe the paying of creditors are too soon, di ba? So the cost of goods sold may be too high and yung expenses are too high. So that summarizes the ratio for profitability and activity ratio natin last time. So for the next meeting, we will discuss the much easier na mga ratio for the company. So after the three parts, so meron na tayong natapos na natin yung part 2 and yung part 3 ng financial statement analysis. I think we will have you will have evaluation quiz and have a short quiz for financial analysis 1 to 3. Okay, so try to review the company profile, yung ating basket wonders, and analyze or understand the formula use for activity ratio and profitability ratio. So guys, I will upload or I will give you the summary of the importance ng bawat ratio to your reference, and you may use it to analyze na rin yung problem. Okay? So thank you for listening to our session for today, and don't forget to evaluate or to answer your evaluation quiz after this, and stay safe. Thank you.